That's not good enough.
That could be anything. That could be water. That could be an animal.
Let's see you walk across the floor.
Stomp. Really stomp. Jump in something. Does that upset you if I kick the gate?
Come on, show us your head.
Doesn't take that much energy to light up this light.
Alright, we're gonna have to walk away.
When I first walked up to the entrance, immediately I heard footsteps coming from inside. So I got Liz to go and check to see round the front of the pier and underneath the pier if there was anyone around or if there's any reason for it. There was a light drizzle happening and drips and splashes were happening all around. But these footsteps sounded very different.
We're going to move on if you don't. Show us that you're here now.
No.
So you're going to have to bang something really loud.
I'm pushing my arm through the gate so much that it actually hurts me.
What was fantastic was, when we reviewed the evidence, there does appear to be the sound of somebody walking on cue towards us.
That could be anything. That could be water. That could be an animal.
Let's see you walk across the floor.
Because I was hearing these footsteps with my own ears and the camera picked them up, I'm convinced that there was some activity there. It would be a fantastic day when we're able to walk onto that pier and do a full investigation around those gatehouses and at the end buildings. Liz and I wanted to walk some of the old pathways and routes around by the reservoir.
See how far we would go before we decide we've had enough, but we're looking for some Foltons.
Now, we'd heard of a murder around that area of Elizabeth Betsy Crowe.
Betsy, if you're around here and you want to talk to us, you can come and talk to us. We've been doing some work at the cottage down the road there. We thought we'd give you an opportunity to speak. You can either come and talk to us directly. Liz has a device in her hand. And I have a device in my hand. If you go near my device, it will light up. If you go near Liz's device, or near both of us, you can talk. And we may be able to hear you later.
You can probably see a light on it. I'm not sure you can or not. All you have to do is go near it or walk past us. You can run past us if you want.
If there's a better place for us to stop, you can set my device off in my hand here and we will stop at that point and allow you to communicate with us if you wish. There's no danger from us. There's no danger at all. They're just people like you. Oh my God.
What?
Can you do that again, please? What was interesting was, as we were walking up, we started getting some EMF hits. Please, can you do that again? I heard a woman's voice, and then this went off the scale. Please, Betsy. Please. We were using the K2 meter because of the low visibility. Do you want us to stop and communicate with you here? It could be the river playing tricks on you.
Yeah, see, I thought I saw something there.
This definitely went off. Just take a step back or two. Just come back down. Betsy, is this the place where you were hit? What was really interesting about these responses was that whenever I mentioned Elizabeth Betsy Crowe, There was no responses.
Was that your voice we heard?
Or is there anybody else here?
Oh my God, did you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're getting hits.
Liz pointed out that it could be somebody else.
Right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hand off this device and I'm going to place it, well, I'm going to put something in it to prove that I'm not manipulating it in any way, shape or form, okay? I'm going to do this thing with the device now, okay? Please don't be afraid, it's just that people will accuse me of lifting my thumb off it or taking the pressure off it. And, I'm not sure whether the person they accused was guilty or not. It seems as the thing seemed to be that they weren't guilty.
What we like doing with EMF hits like that is to see if there's any randomness in them. There seemed to be a high percentage of accuracy when we were asking out.
Come on, Betsy. It's long enough this injustice has been in place, isn't it, really?
Even if you're not Betsy and you want to come and talk to us, just run past us. Just run as fast as you can.
See that?
We knew that the reservoir would have had some sort of automated level check and broadcast regularly to the Isle of Man Water Board.
Is that you? If it is, please come past the device again. Oh, Elizabeth, come on.
But is it somebody else? If it's somebody else, then run past again.
Thank you. So, can you tell us, did you live further up this road? Have you worked here?
So we were quite suspicious about the hits we were getting. However, they did seem to react to what we were saying.
Are you the miller? Do you know Ballure Cottage? Does that look like a signal to you?
So we couldn't rule out completely that these had not affected the EMF hits. What was really interesting was, a couple of days later, Steph, Liz and I had gone up that same road using exactly the same method, exactly the same equipment, and we'd gone up and we virtually got no hits at all. I think we got one at the bottom. This would suggest to us that there was no automated signal affecting what we were doing, otherwise it would have done it on the second night, and secondly, that the Albert Tower aerials weren't affecting or reaching that area. The area is in a very tight valley, and for this reason, radio signals are greatly reduced. What was fascinating to me was that I never realised that Elizabeth Betsy Crow had not been murdered on that road, and every time I asked out for Elizabeth Betsy Crow, there was no response. However, as soon as we started asking out for other people, there was tons of responses. Also, what we didn't know that Johnny and Steph revealed to us later was that in the exact area where we were getting the hits, there had been a terrible car accident. And it's only then that we realised that the place where we were standing was where the wall had been repaired.